In this lesson, we will discuss how to use one-dimensional arrays, which are sometimes called vectors. Many programs require you to store and access a lot of similar data. For example, say you want to develop a program that will calculate the height of a ball dropped from a building every second for 5 seconds. If you want to store this data, you would need to create 6 variables. One variable for the initial height, one variable for the height at 1 second, and so on. Creating only 6 variables would not require a lot of extra work. But what if you want to calculate the height of the ball every 1/100th of a second for 5 seconds? That would require the creation of 501 variables, which would take a very long time to create. In situations where we want to store a lot of similar data, it is often useful to create a single container called an array. An array is conceptually very similar to an Excel spreadsheet, with each value in the array, called an element, given a specific address. All values stored in an array must have the same data type. For example, you cannot store both strings and double precision numbers in the same array. Records allow you to store data with different data types under a single record name, but we will not be discussing records in this course. The simplest types of arrays are one-dimensional and only require you to specify one number to refer to a certain element. The number of elements in an array is determined when declaring the array's data type. You declare arrays in the same manner as you declare variables, except that you also need to specify the number of elements in the array. Let's examine the following declaration statement. Dim A3 as double, B2 as double. This statement creates 2 arrays. The first array, named A, contains 4 elements. 4 locations in memory are set aside for array A to store 4 pieces of information. The second array, named B, contains 3 elements. 3 locations in memory are set aside for the array B to store 3 pieces of information. Each element in an array is given a number, which is also called an index or subscript. By default, the element numbering system starts at 0 and ends at the number listed in the array declaration statement. Many other languages also use 0 as the first element number, but other languages use 1 as the first element number. Let's declare a variable I and give it an integer data type. Just like with variables, all elements in an array that has a numerical data type, such as integer or double, are assigned the value 0. You assign new values to array elements in a similar manner as assigning new values to variables. When referring to a specific array element, you type the array name and the element number in parentheses. B0 equals 2 assigns the value 2 to the first element in array B. B1 equals B0 plus 3 adds 3 to the value stored in B0, which is 2, and the resulting value, which is 5, is assigned to B1. B1 equals B1 plus 1 adds 1 to the value stored in B1, which is 5. 1 plus 5 is 6, and this value is now stored in B1. I equals 1 assigns the value 1 to the variable I. Often a variable, such as I, is used to specify the index number. This next statement assigns the value of bi times bi minus 1 to b2. b1 times b0 is 6 times 2, or 12. If you try to access an array element using an index number that is outside the range of existing index numbers, you will receive an error message. For example, b10 equals 60 is not allowed since the B array does not contain an element with an index number of 10. If you like, you can force the first index number in an array to be a number other than 0 by placing the option base statement before the first subprocedure in a module. By typing option base 1, the first element in each array in the module will have an index number of 1. The last element in the array will have an index number equal to the value in the array declaration statement. The first element in the array A has an index number of 1, and the last element in the array A has an index number of 3. The first element in the array B has an index number of 1, and the last element in array B has an index number of 2. You also have the option of specifying the lower and upper index numbers using the to keyword. Dim A3 to 5 as double creates an array named A whose first index number is 3 and last index number is 5. B negative 1 to 0 as double creates an array B whose first index number is negative 1 and last index number is 0. Loops and arrays are frequently used together in programs because loops allow you to easily access each element in an array, one element at a time. Here's an example that illustrates the power of using loops and arrays together. Let's say we want to calculate the square of all integers from 1 to 5 and store them in an array. Option base 1 forces the first index number in all arrays in this module to be 1 instead of the default value of 0. Inside the macro named main, a constant named n is created and assigned the value 5. An integer array named A is declared, and the last index number in the array is set to n, which is 5. Since the first index of A is 1 and the last index is 5, there are 5 elements in the array A. An integer variable named I also is declared. Then we reach a for loop. I initially is assigned the value 1, and I will increase by 1 each time the next I statement is executed. The loop will terminate when I is greater than n, which is 5. AI equals I squared. Since I currently has the value 1, the element A1 is assigned the value 1 squared, which is 1. Next I increases I by 1, so now I has the value 2. 2 is less than 5, so then we execute the statement AI equals I squared again. Since I now has the value 2, the element A2 is assigned the value 2 squared, which is 4. Next, I increases I by 1, and I now has the value of 3. 3 is less than 5, so we enter the loop again. A3 equals 3 squared. So the element A3 is assigned the value of 9. The loop will be repeated 2 more times, when I is 4, and then 5. When I is 4, A4 is assigned the value of 4 squared, which is 16, and A5 is assigned the value 5 squared, which is 25. The loop is finally terminated when I has the value of 6, since 6 is greater than n. We have stored n values in the array A and can access these values whenever we like later in the program by simply typing the array name and the element's index number. A message box will appear that lists the values stored in the first, second, and last element of the array A. When we run the program, a message box appears that displays the numbers 1, 4, and 25. In this macro, we created a constant n for the highest index number and used this constant at 4 locations in the program. Writing code in this manner allows us to make changes very quickly later on. If suddenly we decide that our program should calculate the square of all integers from 1 to 12 instead of 1 to 5, we can simply change the number 5 at the top of the macro to the number 12 and rerun the program. Since n is 12, an will be 144. If we try to access an array element using an index number that is outside the range of existing index numbers, we will receive an error message. After the message box, we'll type a20 equals 1 and hit the run button. The error message states subscript out of range. This simply means that our index number is outside of the range of existing index numbers for that array.